Welcome everyone to another session of Art of Home Ownership Live. We are about halfway through February already, which is crazy. This is going to be our second session of 2022. So I first want to say thank you for everyone for jumping on and continuing to tune into these. It's been a lot of fun to host and see it gain traction and see you coming back for more. So we're so excited to host another incredible guest with us today. We have Josh Mettle, who is a co-creator of Neo Home Loans. I'm sure a lot of you know of him within the industry. He's done really amazing things. Neo's doing big things in the industry. So Josh, we are excited to host you today and dive into some marketing. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me and thanks for the kind words, Val.
Of course. So if any of you follow Josh on social media, you can see he has really... Josh, you've come into the industry with a marketing background, right?
Well, kind of. The first 10 years of my life in the mortgage world, I was kind of like doing a traditional mortgage thing, which was kind of referral based and past clients. And then after the mortgage meltdown, when my business literally just Chernobyl exploded because of the financial crisis, the mortgage meltdown, I pivoted. And our trajectory here over the last 10 years has been kind of a consumer direct, as I think you've set this up, a niche marketing focus. So I've done both and we continue to do both, but the major focus is towards the niche that we serve.
Yeah, that's awesome. And I think that's really where a lot of mortgage people lack is coming into the industry and then having to figure out the marketing as they go. A lot of people don't have the background coming into it. So it is a lot more difficult to establish that market for yourself and identify who you're trying to target and then create the marketing to reflect that. So we're going to dive into it with Josh today. Josh, can you just start off with a little bit of background about when you got into the industry and kind of who you're trying to target at this point in your career?
Yeah, and I alluded to that just a second ago. So I'll set that up just a little bit better. So you know, the first 10 years, as I mentioned, was very traditional, working with referral partners, working with past clients. When the market shifted, I became really fascinated and I had a lot of extra time because nobody was out there buying houses at the time. And I had a lot of extra time to pursue marketing. And so I got very interested in online marketing and something that's called direct response marketing. Direct response marketing is where you create a message that specifically addresses somebody's problem or challenge or something that they're having a hard time figuring out. And you provide them with a piece of content or information that shows them a path forward. And they say, hey, I need help. You know, I have this problem too, and I need someone who can guide me through whatever I'm going through. And that elicits someone to, you know, click a button or enter in their information, request a consultation, call a phone number, and take a specific response. And so I got really interested in that type of marketing. By the way, if somebody wants a crash course on direct response marketing, go out and buy a couple of the No BS marketing books from Dan Kennedy. And Donald Miller has written two books on marketing. The first one I think is called Becoming a Story Brand. Just Google Story Brand and Donald Miller and you can find him on podcasts and also buy his books. But that would give you if you just did one book from each of those teachers, you'd have a really good foundational knowledge of what is direct response marketing and how do I create a compelling message that's going to create leads and response. So coincidentally, two things were happening at the same time around 2010. My business had blown up and I was ready to take what I'd learned in the first 10 years of my career and figure out how I was going to use that knowledge for the next 10 years in a totally different segment or a totally different, group that I was going to go after and try to help. But up to that point, I'd mostly focused on investors and builders, and both of those segments were not doing great in 2010. So as I was getting fascinated in consumer direct online marketing, I was at the same time working with a local realtor who his wife worked at the University of Utah Hospital, and she was doing all of the kind of onboarding and orientation of doctors that were relocating across the country to come to the University of Utah. And what we were figuring out was in the depths of the mortgage crisis, getting credit as a young doctor was really hard. I mean, if you put yourself empathetically in the position of where these doctors were, they'd spent the last 30 years of their life going through education, undergrad, grad school, their medical degree, then a residency, then a fellowship, then some of them even more specialized than that, racking up all these student loans. So very little income, high indebtedness, relocating their family across the country, trying to buy a jumbo sized mortgage loan with very little money down. What could go wrong, right? And they were having just a hell of a time in the mortgage crash finding financing. So like I said, I had a lot of extra time. All my clients were, you know, really struggling at that period. And so we started to figure out, you know, how do we solve these different challenges that physicians have? And we had a pretty good degree of success at figuring out solutions that other banks and mortgage companies hadn't been able to figure out. And something happened right around that time where I started getting really fulfilled with solving challenges for these clients that other lenders or mortgage advisors or banks hadn't been able to figure out how to get these people into homes. And that was really fulfilling. And at the same time, I started to get this connection to these doctors that were going through this as I learned about their journey and all the years they'd put into their education so that they could take care of people in the hospital systems, that I felt like, man, this is really cool. I get to solve a problem for them and I get to help this clientele or this group that in my time of need, you know, I was having my first kid right around this time. And I'm, you know, in the hospital giving birth, my wife's giving birth to Xander, and I'm feeling really grateful for the doctors and the medical staff that are there giving us advice. And so the first thing I would say as it relates to creating a niche audience is do it for the right reasons. Like, don't go into creating a niche because you want to monetize or make money. That should be a byproduct of the fact that you feel compelled to help this particular group of people because you have a specialized skill set or set of loan products or whatever that enables you to serve these people at a higher level. So for me, that's how it organically originated. I was cultivating my skills in marketing and really fascinated with that. It was just kind of a hobby. And at the same time, I was finding myself really connected from like a heartful level to being able to help these physicians, especially the young physicians who were getting declined with other lenders. And when I could get them into a house, I was just like, poof, like I was just over, you know, over the moon excited. And that that excitement to serve physicians met at the same time as my knowledge with online marketing. And of course, I took what I learned and what I was passionate about, and I put it in on top of online direct response. And, you know, 10 years later, we're on track to probably create about 20,000 leads in 2022 from our various online marketing towards medical professionals and mostly doctors.
That's incredible. And the one thing that I really love what you said, Josh, is do it for the right reasons, which I think really starts at getting into the mortgage industry in general. You have to be in it for the right reasons and want to serve people and genuinely just help people. But I think finding that niche market for yourself is saying, who do I really resonate with, or who do I really work well with? So from your perspective, Josh, what would you say in the mortgage space specifically is a niche market? Are you looking at certain demographics, certain loan types? What would you really categorize that as?
I would just say, speaking kind of from a macro level first, it's anybody that you have a specialized ability to serve or understand. So let's go super broad and let's just say millennials, or let's just say Gen Z. You know, millennials have a different set of challenges, circumstances, fears than maybe boomers do. And if you find yourself in that millennial cohort that is trying to come to terms with, I mean, think about it, you know, I'm a little older, right? I'm before the millennials. I'm Gen X, but that group watched their parents go through the 2000 tech crash, maybe some of the older millennials, and then they watched their parents go through the Great Recession. Many of them lost homes, had to file bankruptcy, divorces because of this traumatic event. And now they're getting into having to invest their money. And that's if you didn't go through that experience and watch that, you can't quite connect as well as if you're in that cohort. So that could be my niche. My niche is helping millennials understand money, become a successful homeowner, and overcome the fears that they picked up from their parents, watching, you know, potentially their parents hit a, you know, financial wall. So that could be a niche for you. Another niche could be there's some guys I know that focus specifically on condos and condo tells and high-rise condos. Like, condos have this more difficult type of underwriting guidelines that if you don't understand the condos, you really can't help those clients at a super high level. So wherever you can serve because you have a unique understanding, empathy, or skill set, or maybe you're even at a bank that has a really cool product, that's a great way to identify a niche. And again, I would just preface that by saying, go into it because you want to help people, and the money, the success will follow.
Right. So if someone was currently in the industry, because I think this is kind of a chicken or the egg situation. So you were already in the industry when you really identified the physician niche as your specialty. But for someone who has not identified that for themselves, would you say that it's best to establish, okay, this is going to be my niche, I'm just starting out in the industry, and this is what I'm going to focus on? Or do you wait over time and see, who do I work the best with? What am I really good at? And then kind of establish that as your niche and go that route.
Yeah, I would just say have an awareness around it. You know, as you're going through your day or your business, or maybe you're taking a time out to reflect upon the loans that you've done over the last 6 or 12 months, and you start to have an awareness of, who are the clients that I love working with? Who are the clients that I just seem to gel with, and we have a great time working together? And who are the clients that I seem to have the greatest amount of value? And if you just have an awareness, and where you put your attention is where you put your energy, and just start putting your attention on those particular clients, and maybe just take some notes. You know, a lot of loan officers will keep a pipeline where all their past clients and their loans closed. And I've done that for 15 years. So I've got an Excel document that goes back and shows me all those clients for 15 years. I use it as clients go through the loan process, because it helps me compile my notes and are they locked and who's the realtor working with that client and those things. But I also started a section that I just would have general notes on those clients and make it really easy for me to go back and go, all right, what's the commonalities amongst the clients that I love working with, that I'm the most valuable, that appreciate me the most? And can I find a commonality that then becomes a niche that I can start to advertise and really serve?
Yeah, that's a great transition into the next point, which is, and Josh, I think you do this really well, which is incorporating that niche into your marketing and kind of reflecting that in the content that you're putting out. In what ways does it make marketing either A, easier or more effective by identifying that niche and then having that be reflective in the content that you're putting out?
Great question. Really, really good question. This is probably the most important question of all. Once you identify who your ideal client is, there's a marketing guy that I followed for a long time. His name was Frank Kern. And he taught me to create what's called an ideal customer avatar. It's like a visual image of the person that you want to connect with or that you want to get your message to. And Frank says you should name that person. You should know how many kids they have, how old they are, how much money they have, what their problems are. You should know their problems better than they know their problems, because you've worked with 50 of those, let's just call them Vals, I've worked with 50 vals and I really want, and I know the problems that Val's going to have before she even knows those problems, because I've traveled that journey with the 50 clients before her. And I would think every time I create a marketing message, the first thing that I would be saying to myself is, who is this marketing message for? Oh, it's for Val, right? Val is the young millennial buying her first home with a little bit of student debt and trying to pay down those credit cards and not enough money down. I don't mean to pigeonhole you there, Val. I'm just trying to create like a customer avatar that would be the person that I was going after. And then I would say, okay, what are Val's challenges? What are Val's problems? What is she going to experience? So I'd figure out, you know, who is it that I want to get my message to? What's my customer avatar? For me, that was physicians, young physicians that were having a hard time getting financing. What are their problems that they're going to encounter or that they are already encountering? And then how can I help them overcome those problems? And that's really the formula. If we speak to our customer avatar, the ideal customer that we want to serve, the person buying the high-rise condo, the person buying their first home, the person that needs to do a jumbo mortgage with little down and they're self-employed and so they've got messed up, whatever that is, we speak to them and we want to identify for that customer avatar what is their challenges. Then we want to speak with them with empathy. We want to tell them that we understand what they're going through. We want to show authority. We've helped many clients that have your exact same situation successfully navigate those challenges that we just talked about. And then we want to show them a path forward, which is, you know, click here or request your consultation or do this specific action so I can help you overcome the challenges that you're about to run into.
And how do you how does your organic content also reflect the same thing? Are you using that same kind of formula to formulate your organic content as you are your ad strategy?
Totally. Yeah. So I'm constantly scouring different media sources, Mortgage Daily News, Barry Habib's stuff, Housing Wire, a bunch of economic forecasters that I read their stuff. And I'm just trying to find out, like, what are the hot buttons in the industry right now? What do people not understand? What's holding them back? And then I want to talk about those problems. And then I want to position something that I know or something I can help somebody do that will overcome those challenges. So I'm looking or trying to curate whatever the focal point in the news is that might be a challenge to my target market that I'm going after. Yeah. And then I want to talk about that problem. And then I want to talk about a solution to help people get over that problem. So for example, like this Friday, I think it's like 2:30 or something like that. I have a realtor friend and longtime realtor partner of mine. We've been working together for over 10 years now. And we're going to talk about the challenges that sellers are having, not buyers, but sellers are having, because sellers can sell their home tomorrow. But if they're anything like me, I got a 10-year-old girl and a 12-year-old boy, and I don't want them to be homeless. Yeah. So I've got to overcome the obstacle of, great, you can sell my home in 48 hours, but where am I going to go? Yeah. How do I solve that problem? Because the real estate market is essentially frozen because people who want to move can't figure out how to do it and not put their kids at risk and their family at risk of being homeless. So that's a problem. And I'm going to, whenever I land on one of those, I'm going to start speaking to that problem and then speaking to how we help clients overcome that common problem that people are experiencing.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's really insightful. And what would you say, Josh, is the dynamic between, let's say you establish that niche market for yourself. What about business coming in that might not be in that niche market? Like, where do you kind of draw the line and say, this is where I'm going to focus? Or can you have multiple niche markets? Like, how do you see that kind of playing out for people?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of my clients that came from referral partners or came from past clients aren't necessarily in the medical industry. Yeah. So I spend probably 80 to 90% of our energy marketing directly towards that ideal customer avatar. This is the type of clientele that I know that we have superpowers when it comes to serving those clients. And that's where I'm going to spend the majority of my time, spending talking about their specific problems and our solutions. But guess what? Guess what doctors' biggest problems in buying a home today? It's finding a home. It's actually getting crafting an offer that gets them under contract. It's figuring out, how do I sell my home and buy a new home? So right now, whether you're the general public or whether you're a doctor, you're experiencing a lot of the same problems. And then also those doctors have compounding additional problems of student loans, trying to buy jumbo homes with limited down payments, relocating across the country, and they don't have a paycheck stub from their new job, but they want to buy a house before they start. So they have all those problems too. But you know, sometimes there's some crossover, but 80 to 90% of my time is spent just thinking about what are the problems that the doctor is having as they relocate across the country, take a new job, and want to buy their house.
Yeah. And do you think that it's possible to have, because I talk to loan officers on a regular basis that say, you know, I specialize in both regular conventional and veteran loans, VA loans. Mm-hmm. Would you say that it's possible to have two niche markets? And how does that kind of reflect in your content as well?
Well, when I think about the difference between VA and conventional, those are just two different tools. Like what you're really talking about is somebody in the military who, and you, it may serve them better to get a VA loan, or it may serve them to get a conventional loan. So I'd certainly want all those tools in my tool belt. But in terms of my advertising, my marketing, how I'm trying to get my persona out there, I would want to consistently speak to the military, to the military veteran, and I would want to identify what their specific challenges are and talk to them. Now, I may do a conventional loan or I may do a VA loan, but I would want the vast majority of my messaging to be directly to the military or veteran if that was who I felt uniquely suited to serve.
Yeah, that's awesome. All right, Josh, one takeaway for anyone that has not identified their niche market for themselves. So what is one actionable thing that they can be doing to either figure out what that is or work it into their marketing if they already know that?
Super good question. I'll share with you how I stumbled upon the medical professional or doctor niche. Because you know, all these things were kind of happening in my life at the same time, but I hadn't put together all the sides of the Rubik's Cube, if you will, right? And my coach at the time was Bill Hart, incredible coaching mentor, and really saved me after the mortgage meltdown and got me refocused and back on the trajectory that I've been following for the last decade. And Bill said, you know, why don't you spend an hour early in the morning and go back over all of the clients that you've served for the last year and try to reflect upon the ones that you really enjoyed working with and had a high degree of connection. You know, the conversation wasn't about rate. It was about, how can I help this family? You know, there was that kind of like energetic connection. And then try to find a commonality, like highlight all the, so literally I went to my Excel spreadsheet, I highlighted all those people, and you know, the names of the people you really resonate with, names like jump off the page, like, I remember that family, that was awesome. So I'd highlight all those people in a color, and then I'd go back and I'd try to figure out what's the commonality with these people. And what I found was, going back over the last 12 months, I think I highlighted 14 names that just jumped off the page. And, you know, we probably had closed, I don't know, a couple hundred loans, let's just say. And there was 14. And unbeknownst to me, 9 of those 14 were all doctors or medical professionals. And I went, oh my gosh, I didn't even really fully get it that, you know, I had this great connection with doctors. And so that's what I'd recommend. I'd recommend you go back over your previous year and find the people that you resonate, that you really made a difference in their life, and try to figure out the commonality. Do they work in a specific field? Do they buy high-rise condos? And you know how to figure those out better than anybody. Were they buying properties in rural areas with USDA financing? Because you know USDA better than anybody. Like, try to find out who is it that you really have an energetic connection with that you can really serve at a high level or have a specialized skill. And then once you've identified that group, start thinking about what their problems are and start writing and filming videos talking about the problems that are commonplace for that group and how you have a specialized skill set or ability to help families overcome those problems. That's the recipe.
Yeah. That's awesome. Super tactical. And I think that does a number of things, because not only is it going to improve your client process because you're going to be working with those people better than anyone else, but then it also takes weight off your shoulders when it comes to marketing. And it's going to make that process so much easier because the content is just going to come to you once you identify who that audience is. So, John Gold.
Val, thanks. I appreciate it. Let me give you one more bonus piece of advice. Oftentimes when we start to become the educator, the teacher, we have this moment of self-doubt. Like, oh, I don't know everything. And am I really qualified? I've only been in the industry for 1 year. Am I really qualified to speak to this? And I don't want to sound stupid. First of all, that's totally normal. Okay. Just acknowledge that. Like, okay, everybody goes through this. And then think this. I know more than 99% of the clients that I talk to, even though I've only been doing this for a year or 2 years or whatever. I know more than 99% of the clients that I talk to. And I need to be worried about how I can add value to those 99% and not worried that somebody somewhere is going to hear me and they think I'm stupid. Just help the people that you can help and know that you know more than your clients and just step into the light and be a teacher.
Absolutely. Listen to Josh. He knows what he's talking about. This is a great recipe to follow. Josh, thank you so much for joining us today. This was really tactical, great information. We appreciate you hopping on.
My pleasure. Thanks, AOH team.
Thanks everyone for watching. We'll see you.